at just in your word, we rejoice at your giving birth. He came to turn the dark to light, to shed his grace on all mankind, and by grace we are saved from sin. The prophets told of his good birth, that he'd be king forevermore, and someday he'd come again. O Lord, we praise and honor you, we glorify and bless you, as you grant us eternal life. O Master, Savior, come to us, come dwell in us, be born in us, shine on us your heavenly light.
Imagine for a moment that you live in Israel, just over 2,000 years ago. The Jews live every day wondering when the promised Messiah will come to rescue them from the dreaded Roman occupation. Many attribute this occupation to Israel's sinfulness, their abandonment of God, just as the prophets had said during their previous slavery in Egypt, and then again in Babylon. A message of hope, of peace, and of freedom, and the promised Messiah is all they have left to hold on to. Around the Temple Mount, Pharisees argue for their belief in the resurrection of the soul and body in heaven. The Sadducees reject that claim, as well as the existence of angels. Another sect in Judaism, known as the Essences, leave the city and travel into the desert to live in solitude, in caves near the Dead Sea as monks and hermits. There they write on parchment about their beliefs in the resurrection, about their hopes for the coming Messiah, and about their new practice of baptizing those who join their sect and seek an intimate relationship with God. As the expectation of the Messiah grew, the Archangel Gabriel was sent by God to a young girl named Mary, the daughter of a pious couple, Joshua and Anna. Mary, at the age of 3, had been brought by her parents to the temple to be raised as a nun by the temple priest to bring her whole life to God. In her, God the Father felt it most proper to send his Spirit to conceive his eternal Son in the flesh, to be born into the world, and to take on human nature and ultimately save his children and his creation from death.
Thank you. is willed that all of his children should come to know his son Jesus as Abraham and Moses, as David and all the faithful men and women have known God. Jesus will not simply be a special man or an angel of God. He will be God himself in the flesh, for you know that his name is God with us. To protect you and the child you bear, an older man named Joseph has also been chosen by God. He already has a son named James, a faithful boy that loves God with his whole heart. Since Joseph was in the family of David the king, he needed to go from his home in Nazareth to Bethlehem for the Roman census. This fulfilled the prophecy that said the Messiah was to come from Bethlehem, but was called Nazareth. As the young family approached Bethlehem, a problem soon became evident. Various town people said, "Can you believe how crowded it is here? All of us have been looking for a place to stay for days, but there's no room anywhere." It is indeed very crowded, but it is most important that Joseph and Mary find shelter somewhere. "People, come this way. Let us follow the bright star from the Holy Spirit who will witness the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior."
Oh, there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. He is the anointed one, the one you have been expecting, the one that will truly save his people. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. The shepherds looked up and said, the angels of God are singing to our newborn king, the Messiah that the scripture says to come from the city of David. Let us now go to Bethlehem to see what has happened, for God has blessed us with his vision and made this known to us. As the shepherds heard the angels of God singing, they realized this was no ordinary event, nor would their lives ever be the same. As Jesus himself then knew the scriptures, the shepherds made their way to Bethlehem with an open heart to see what had happened.
Thank you. true miracle of Christmas is not so much in his conception, or in the angels, or in the star the Magi followed. It is to be found in our God's sacrificial love for his children. Only in Christianity is God so defined by this one characteristic. St. John the Evangelist said it best when he wrote that all Christians would be defined by their love for their brothers and sisters. Because love is of God, and God is love. With all the music, the performances, and the celebrations surrounding Christmas, it is sometimes difficult to remember that the most astounding message of the Nativity is that God became a human being. In every Orthodox church around the world, it is the icon of the Incarnation, the Virgin Mary with the Christ Child, that takes a central position on the iconostasis and reminds us every day of just how much God loves us. We thank you for giving us your attention this morning and pray that our Lord Jesus Christ will once again be born in the hearts of all his children and bring peace to the world.
About it is the greatest thing that we could ever hope for.